And welcome, everybody, to Central Valley Today. Happy Wednesday. I'm Stephanie Bainham.
And I'm Alex Delgado. We appreciate you being here with us today. You know, we're going to start off with something pretty interesting. When you work hard for your money, you want to protect it, right? From things like creditors, lawsuits, divorce, and even judgments. But how do you do that? Asset protection is the key to making sure that you do not lose everything in a lawsuit.
So joining us now to explain how he can help is Michael Braa. He's the owner of Atlantis Private Investigations. Michael, great to see you again.
Welcome to be back.
Yes. I think asset investigations is something that many folks aren't as familiar with, but can you kind of set the basics here?
Yeah, sure. The reason I'm so popular in doing this, people like to look to me, is because, as we talked before in my past as an attorney, I used to put these entities together to protect people's assets, and so I have a natural ability to kind of find them if I need to.
Mm-hmm. Why would you need to do that in cases such as the ones we just mentioned, like divorce?
Yeah, the two most popular ones are in dissolution, divorce, mm-hmm. or with an attorney who's doing due diligence. Mm-hmm. We've talked about due diligence in the past. The attorney has to check off some boxes mm-hmm. to make sure that they're not going to get themselves in any kind of trouble. Before an attorney wants to do a lawsuit that might spend a lot of money on, he wants to make sure there's money they can get back, and so they'll come to us and say, can you look into this particular person, see if he's got the assets and if they're hidden somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And the other one, of course, is the divorce, which is very common. Beforehand, a spouse might be putting money away somewhere, trying to hide it in anticipation of the divorce.
Mm-hmm.
After the divorce, there may be issues of child support. When you first have the hearing, you usually give disclosures, you give money, but things change after time. So, you know, several years down the line, you might have a question, has the income changed or the expenses
yeah.
different?
Mm. So if you feel like things are going downhill in your marriage, would you recommend perhaps hiring a PI to check out the asset situation before?
If you have some suspicion, there's really no reason to do it during a typical divorce, but if you have some suspicion that it might be happening, it's a pretty good idea to do. Usually the attorney will get a hold of me and say, can you take a look at this one? We just want to be sure something's not right.
Yeah. So does the person that is taking the money, would that person get in trouble, or is it just one of these things where you just want your money back, so we hire you because we want our money back?
The person can get in trouble. At the beginning of a divorce, you sign a declaration of disclosure mm-hmm. saying that you've told the other party where everything is. There's usually not a problem. But if you do sign that disclosure and then later on I find out that you squirreled some money away somewhere,
yeah.
it can be contempt of court and you can get in trouble for it.
Wow.
Talk about the trusts, corporations, foreign companies. Are these people that would need to hire you as well?
Those are actually different entities that are used in order to protect assets. The most popular is corporation. Many businesses decide either incorporate or provide LLCs. It's an actual entity, like a different person, a fictitious person that can control the assets. So knowing how these are formed allows me to locate them. Once you know how to do them, you can find them.
Mm.
What is interesting is I had mentioned the corporation and the trust is because there is something called an offshore asset protection trust, where they use the corporation and they use the trust to hide money offshore.
Ooh.
And they can actually give directions to the trust so that if the person ever gets in trouble and gets sued, the trust can take the money, and then you have to get through the laws of Belize or the Isle of Man
wow.
or the Cook Islands. You have to get through their legal system to try and get to the assets.
I can tell that you've done that because of the fact that you mentioned those places.
Yeah. It's one of the many little tricks that I learned about while practicing law.
Oh, okay. So you look for those when you're investigating someone's assets.
Yes, and other things too. I'm really easy if you want to look at my assets because I have an LLC under the name of my company, Atlantis Private Investigations. I'm very open and upfront with it. And if you look on my website, it says Michael Braa owns it.
Yeah.
But if I wanted to be tricky, I might create a different entity with a different name and hide my assets under there. Then you can't find it by looking by my name.
Yes.
And that's what you do. You go out and find
them. I go out and find them.
Wow. So you identify, you locate, and then you put value on whatever.
That's why my job's so easy. I just have to do
that. Well, it's not easy.
Not at all.
Yeah.
Wow.
It seems like someone would get in trouble, perhaps, for doing some of that stuff. Is that right?
There are things you can do that are shady, but the things that I've talked about here today are all above the board and legal.
Kind of sounds like a dangerous job, if you ask me. Like, you should be on TV or something, you know. Wait, you are?
I don't think it's dangerous. I think it's kind of interesting and fun. It's a puzzle for me. I like solving the puzzle.
Yeah, wow. That's amazing. Okay, so Michael, how do we go about hiring you, or when would we know that we would need you for something?
Well, if you ever wonder if you need me, give me a call, 559-478-8220. I'll chat with you for a few minutes on the phone, or if you'd like a consultation, you can come on in, speak with me for an hour. No charge to talk.
Yeah.
So if you're in doubt, you can give me a call.
Yeah. I like that.
If you want more information, you can always visit my website, www.atlantisinvestigations.com.
So there are various situations where you can get hired and help people, right?
Absolutely.
Because I think a lot of people are under the misconception that you just go after people who might be, you know, cheating on their spouse. But no, there's so much more to you. Attorney due diligence, family law, divorce. Do you recommend anyone who's going through a divorce? And I think Steph may have asked this, but calling you ahead of time just to make sure everything's in order?
It can't hurt.
Okay.
And I know the questions to ask. And if you have any doubt about these things, anything that has to do with money and finances being hidden or people working under the table, that's kind of one of the areas that I specialize in. And I you know, feel free to give me a call and talk about it.
Because I'm sure you've seen this before. When it comes to money, people kind of change, don't they?
Oh, boy.
They do. Well, we have a joke around my offices. The two things people will fight to the death for are family and property.
Uh-huh.
And then the family fights for the property within the family.
Absolutely.
Or the money. All right. Well, definitely, I'm sure many people can use your services. So give Michael a call. There's that number on your screen. And we will see you next time with another interesting topic to talk
Cheaters
about.
Cheaters next time.
Oh.
Just for you guys.
Because we always ask about it. Thanks, Michael.